There's something inside you that doesn't belong. It creeps into your body through the guise of harmless kitchen paraphernalia. The lining of chicken noodle soup cans in the pantry. The food storage containers in the cupboard. The 12-pack of cola and bottles of spring water in the fridge. It even seeps into your microwave dinner. It's everywhere. It's a foreign chemical that is ingested into your body daily, a mysterious substance whose negative effects are not yet fully understood. Bisphenol A, generally known as BPA, is the commonly used chemical that interacts with the endocrine system. The endocrine system is important because it regulates our body's natural hormones like estrogen and testosterone. Estrogen helps develop female characteristics, while testosterone develops male traits. BPA is chemically related to estrogen by the alcohol groups OH. Bisphenol A is a major byproduct of the breakdown of epoxy resin and polycarbonate plastics. Epoxy resin is used to coat the inner lining of metal cans and provides a barrier between the metal and the substance of the can. BPA is also in clear, see-through polycarbonate plastics like water bottles and food storage containers. Poly means many, and carbon is the core building block of the overall molecular chain structure of polycarbonate plastics. The interactions between the many polycarbonate chains in plastics are much like the mortar that adheres the individual brick blocks to form a fortified building. The strength of these interactions allow the polycarbonate chains to be sturdy. Just as a bulldozer is required to demolish a brick building, a strong force such as heat or acid would be needed to break down the chains. The heat force needed ranges from room temperature to microwave-induced heat. Acidic forces are corrosive and recognized by the bitter and/or sour taste that's in soda pop, canned fruits, and coffee. These forces disrupt the interactions between the polycarbonate chains, releasing BPA compounds. So, how does BPA get into our bodies? BPA compounds leach from the container into the food or drink. After consumption, the BPA compounds are absorbed from the stomach into the bloodstream. They continue to travel freely through the reproductive organs, kidneys, and stomach, competing with estrogen for binding to estrogen receptors. When either chemical binds to the receptor, this activates production of compounds needed for reproductive functions like menstruation and sperm production. BPA is then either excreted out of the body through urine or stored in fat tissue. To research the level of BPA in urine, a study was conducted by Dr. Antonio Calafé and other researchers at the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention in 2004. This research was supported by the following organizations. Researchers measured the concentration of bisphenol A from 394 human urinary samples. To this date, the Food and Drug Administration has asserted that 50 micrograms per kilogram is a safe daily consumable amount of BPA for humans. The study showed that BPA was detected in 95% of the samples at concentrations greater than 0.1 micrograms per liter. With these seemingly small levels of BPA in the body, effects would be presumed to be irrelevant. However, recent research has indicated that these small levels of BPA interacting with estrogen receptors can produce profound effects on the reproductive system in rodents. Low-dose exposure to BPA during development leads to premature loss of a consistent estrous cycle, which shortens the duration of fertility in females. In male rodents, BPA was shown to reduce sperm count. Researchers speculate in humans the early onset of puberty in females could be correlated with high exposure to BPA. In addition, some studies have shown that negative health effects can be seen at as little as 0.025 micrograms per kilogram of BPA, rather than the 50 micrograms per kilogram that the FDA accepts. The debate continues as surfacing research shows negative correlations between reproductive health and BPA. Further research is needed to make a more educated assessment of human exposure to BPA. In our society that is structured by plastics, there are safe alternatives to BPA. Several water bottle companies have switched to BPA-free plastics, making them safe to reuse. Also, there are multiple companies that make aluminum or stainless steel water bottles. Another way to avoid BPA leaching is to reheat food on ceramic kitchenware instead of in the plastic container. Making these conscious health decisions can lower your exposure to BPA and keep you safe from this foreign chemical whose destructive effects are yet to be fully comprehended.